Yes, you can have it all.
Hello, good evening, and thank you for joining us for another edition of News 360, coming to you live from the News Hub here at Adisa Wakanda. I am Portia Gabo.
And I am Komla Adoma. Top stories this evening. In our bulletin this evening, the first ever national standardized test for primary four pupils takes place amidst complaints of late starts. We'll be having a discussion on the assessment of the exam.
Also tonight, Accra International Conference Center to make way for a new one, but there are already question marks over the transparency of the process.
Also this evening, Doma Hene takes on government over development in the Bono region. We'll hear from him.
Also in the bulletin, we access some of the proposed constitutional changes in the NPP as the party gathers in Kumasi for its delegates conference.
We have details of these stories and more, including sports and entertainment, if you stay with us over the next 60 minutes. Let's begin, however, from a story that's just coming through, and the Finance Committee of Parliament has suspended the consideration of the Electronic Transactions Levy Bill 2021. That's a development coming through from Parliament. We're joined on the line by Komla Kluche, our Parliamentary Affairs Correspondent, to give us the latest. Komla, do we know exactly why the suspension of a consideration of this particular bill or the levy? Komla Kluche. Hello, Komla Kluche. I want to know what the basis for the suspension of the consideration of this is. I'm afraid Komla Kluche cannot hear me. We'll be working the phone lines, try to get a better connection to him. The story from Parliament as we speak is that the Finance Committee of the House has suspended consideration of the Electronic Transactions Levy Bill 2021. And you know that this is such a subject that's been a subject of controversy over the period. We'll be getting back to Komla Kluche. He will give us the details as and when we're able to establish connection with him.
In more news tonight, the first ever national standardized test has ended across the country with claims of late starts in some regions. We will hear from the Ashanti region later. But first, in the Greater Accra region, almost 50,000 primary four pupils took part in the examination. The test at some centers started late because officials say vehicular traffic in the capital delayed the arrival of exam materials.
By 11 a.m., pupils had started the test at some centers.
So far, so good, except that we faced the challenge of distributing the papers because of traffic situation in Greater Accra.
The exam was organized by the West African Examination Council, WAEC, in literacy and numeracy.
This year, we are assessing primary four students, and then we have primary five to do intervention for those who are not doing well. And then primary six will test them again. This is an initiative that is supposed to help Ghana achieve academically and at the same time ensure that we are given the opportunity for intervention. So this data that is going to come out of this exam is going to be used by GES to plan professional development, or what is called INSET, for teachers to improve their skills. The results from this exam will go to parents so that they know how well their students or their worth are doing. Yes, sir.
The education minister said private schools could be included subsequently if they showed interest. 48,745 pupils sat for the test in Greater Accra. Some of the pupils were excited after the test.
It's very simple for me. The one that I not dealing with is the mathematics. I am not good in mathematics.
Is it different from your normal classes that you have been doing from your teachers?
And some is different and some is the same. So.
I perform well. I thought it could be hard, but it's not hard.
It was very easy for us.
Well, in the Ashanti region, our correspondent Ibrahim Abubakar reports that the maiden edition of a national standardized test was greeted with mixed reaction among the class 4 pupils.
The exams, scheduled to begin at 9 a.m., delayed for more than 2 hours at both the Presbyterian Basic School and Ahmadiyya Basic School centers. This was due to late arrival of the papers at the center. Some of the pupils also had to come from far places to the examination center. At 11:30 a.m., all were seated for the first paper to begin. In an hour later, they were done with the mathematics subject. English language shortly followed, and soon the pupils came out smiling. They were excited to have written the test and hoped for good grades.
How did the exams go?
The exams was going well, and I was able to do it well.
What you learned, was it the same thing that appeared?
Yes, it was the same thing appeared in the exams paper. It was a little hard for me, but it is good for me to write the exams. To pass it so that my family will be happy for me, to appreciate me with good things.
It was simple for me, and it was well. I want my school to be first.
Are you sure that what you've written can earn you 100%?
Yes.
The National Standardized Test is aimed at evaluating learning outcomes in English and mathematics for learners in class 4. Ibrahim Abubakar, TV3 News, Kumasi.
Let's head back to Parliament, where the stories are the Finance Committee has suspended the consideration of the Electronic Transactions Levy Bill 2021. Kumla Kluche, Parliamentary Affairs Correspondent, is joining us. Kumla, why has the committee suspended this particular consideration? I'm afraid we have lost Kumla Kluche there again on the line. We'll be working the line to get through to him. As and when we get him, we'll engage him.
So in Parliament, the Accra International Conference Centre is to be pulled down, paving way for the construction of a new one at the consideration of over 574 million cedis 2022 budget estimate for the Foreign Affairs Ministry. The ranking member on the Foreign Affairs Committee, Samuel Okudjetua-Blackwa, disclosed that the minority is not against the construction, which has become necessary over decay of the facility, but rather transparency in the process. But the Foreign Affairs Minister has a short of value for money.
Very, very worried about this, and we have not been able to resolve this matter, and Mr. Speaker, we'll be relying on your counsel on the way forward. Mr. Speaker, the other matter that is of concern to us is plans by the Ministry to bring down the conference center, the Accra International Conference Center, and construct a new conference center. The facility is quite in a distressed state, and it is a looming disaster. We are not against some work going on at the Accra International Conference Center based on expert advice from the engineers. What we are concerned about, Mr. Speaker, is the lack of transparency in how the plans are to reconstruct a new edifice at a whopping amount of 116,384,500 euros.
On the issue, Mr. Speaker, which the ranking member raised of the Accra International Conference Centre, I would like to assure this August House that value for money audit will be done. Secondly, the procurement or the project has gone through a PPA, and so we will put every single detail before the committee. and if necessary, before this House. Indeed, it will come to this House, and for the House to either accept or to decline it. There are no issues to be raised at this stage because it will come before this August House.
Away from Parliament, let's go to the Ashanti region, where there is an easy calm at Nyenewusu, a mining community in the Trimampunya district, following alleged killing of five illegal miners by some community members. Reports say the victims were mistaken for armed robbers. Disturbing pictures of the murdered miners showed some with their throats slit. The Trimampunya District Security Council is considering military intervention to quell a possible reprisal attack. Bodies of the victims have been deposited at the Afari Hospital Community Morgue, and we'll be joined on the phone line by ASP Godwin Ahianyo, the Ashanti Regional Police PRO, for more details. Thank you so much for your time, sir. First of all, what is the security situation there, especially as the Trimampunya District was considering military intervention to quell reprisal attacks?
Thank you very much for your question. Let me extend my greetings to your cherished viewers. I must say it's too early in the day to call for military intervention because, as we speak, calm has returned to the area. As of this morning, the regional police commander has dispatched a team of personnel from the regional command to augment the strength of our men on the ground. So I can definitely tell you that there is calm in the area. I just spoke to the district commander and he tells me they were there in the afternoon with the district chief executive and they spoke to the community members and assured them of our investigations, which is ongoing, and that everything that we're supposed to do to bring the case or this matter to its legal conclusion will be done. So I can assure you that there's calm in the area.
Have you made any arrests yet?
So far, we've not made any arrests, but we are in touch with the chief of the area. He's assured us and the opinion leader that they are going to assist the police because yesterday the chief himself was a victim. He was assaulted when he tried rescuing the victims. So I'm sure and hopeful that they are all going to assist us in this case. So pretty soon we'll get them arrested and bring them to justice.
Now, those killed were alleged to be illegal miners. Does this suggest that galamsey is still ongoing in that community?
We know that the area is a mining area, and we used to record robberies on that stretch. Because of that, we have been giving the commuters on that stretch escort from Kwanfifi up to Kotokrom. We've been providing security on that stretch. And because of the robbery area, the nature of the area, mostly we ensure that the commuters go in convoy. So this month, yesterday, when we got information that some suspected armed robbers had been arrested, we proceeded there to make sure we get them. It was rather unfortunate that this happened, but I'm showing the general public that the command is investigating the matter, and then we'll be able to unravel the circumstances that led to the attack on these young men.
Thank you so much for your time. ASP Godwin Ahianyo is the Ashanti Regional Police PRO.
Let's still stay with the police and crime because the Inspector General, George Ekufu Dampare, has appealed to residents of Doba and Kandiga to forgive one another and give peace a chance for the total development of the area. The IGP visited the two communities as part of his emergency visit to the Upper East region. Dr. George Ekufu Dampare and the Regional Security Council called on the traditional rulers of both communities at their respective palaces as a way of bringing down the tension in the area. The IGP admonished them to allow the laws of the land to prevail rather than violence because the two communities, Doba and Kandinga, are all one family. More than seven people have lost their lives and several houses have been burned since communal conflicts, which has to do with a land boundary dispute which started last year.
Meanwhile, the Secretary General of the Ghana Catholic Bishop Conference, Father Lazarus Anondi, is appealing to government to offer interventions to aid victims of clashes between some residents of Doba and Kandiga in the Kasina Nangana municipality of the Upper East region. Seven residents were killed in the clashes and several others were rendered homeless after their houses were razed in the aftermath of the conflict.
The Upper East really found it so unfortunate that such a conflict is going on, and they have become very concerned and are intervening in their own way, trying to find an amicable settlement of it. And they have set up a committee, a reconciliation committee being headed by our respected retired Justice of the Supreme Court, Justice William Matuga. So he is the one heading that committee, and they are doing tremendous job. And even the people themselves are trying to sponsor this from their own resources, but it's not enough. And I think perhaps it is an opportunity for the government to give a push to a committee like that. It's an unfortunate situation. We think in Ghana we love to live in peace, and we can only develop in peace. We can't develop in conflict. So I would say the powers that be should pay attention to this conflict, see how they can intervene in whatever way possible to have an amicable settlement. An amicable settlement. That is the only way, so that everybody wins. It's not one party winning and the other losing, because that doesn't help. It doesn't build relationships afterwards. But where there's they settle their differences amicably, then there's that understanding that, this is how we have concluded, and this is how the way we should go. And that really continues to help them to build bridges amongst themselves.
In more stories tonight, the Domahene and president of the Bono Regional House of Chiefs, Osagyefo Osadieyo Ajimambedu, has descended heavily on government after what he says is a complete neglect of the region. In a no-holds-barred message before the Regional House of Chiefs, Osagyefo Ajimambedu said that many uncompleted projects in the region is discriminatory against the Bono people.
As a matter of urgency, you demand this abandon. Onke kana ho. Abadia. Airport. Sugana Airport. Abunofo first in airport ibununga afo. Ningina na be yusu. Yet he say ba kwa big grind. Sikapoti na ba de yoye kakra na okwa chirin. Nkran ne de ya capital oyɛ. Ofriwa. The next year, I will have a Kumasi. She is sick of it. Buy a phase one, buy a phase two, and now Kumasi Airport. Come here, Koso. Koho Airport, Kowa Airstrip, Kotemali, Yura. Abe born in the eye. Say airport, we. Menka Emma Nana Dongwa. Yewra John Mahama ne penso boso medu nwotwe otratre ho sa anyo ne beja ho na aban foforo bai na yewra ho de na de achere mfie num nie okomfie num airport baako ho nye mae ema nipa ne nyina gadie ne nyina ko ba bi baako pe ema bonofo ye ho achere ye face the country for no. I said na de wi ase no bia ntimi mfa ho nzie o Dr. Ren ayi ohene David maami bie Freema shows Chine Jonas alias Grass Nkwa yewura bibia ba ka no obia ka kiro se nyansa nima oboa nyansa wo mti ye no de yesre obia se Yanabaka, the form said, attempt the Nibijai. Lamon, Baba, I can't want ye. Debate a quana of us, I miss me to me, yet to me mobile. Nambo niema nkura no ka no. Sɛ de ye ya brabo a ebetuma ye de. Ede nkɔso obeba.
So essentially what he's been speaking about is the lack of development in the area. He raises a concern specifically about the Suyang Airport, which has been abandoned for more than 5 years, and calls on government to, as a matter of urgency, fix it, because he compares it to the Ho and the Kumasi airports, which have seen some completion. He also touches on the Fix the Country agitations and says government must take seriously the message of these campaigners and why development must be spread across the country and specifically brought to his region. So those are the words of the king of the Bono region there.
Well, still on development in the Bono region, the issue of the Sunyain Airport, which has been out of use for more than 5 years, is particularly important to the Bono people. And now the regional minister, Justina Owusu-Banaheni, claims the first phase should be completed by the end of January.
By January ending, because they can't say, I'm the bitumen.
The last coat of bitumen has been laid. When that dries, the transport minister, together with the engineers, will come and do the technical inspection. That should complete the first phase of the airport project.
They will come and do the technical and the engineering.
The contractor working on the second phase, which includes the arrival hall, is nearing completion too. Everything is on course.
He is also doing the second phase. Into a pa arrival hall no so and also so no. In fact, we could do here there. What pa name so a different from the air tiles on the day. I don't know. Means me more dancing. But he's on course, and I said they are there.
Now, a member of a minority section of a Finance Committee of Parliament says they will test the legality of imposition of the e-levy. The bill was laid before Parliament on Thursday with some modifications, but the 1.75% tax rate is still intact. Member of Parliament for Ho, Benjamin Kpodo, is still unsure about the levy, but another member of the Finance Committee, Stephen Amoah, says the NPP will stand by the e-levy policy.
He has not met our demands. The bill is here, I'm holding it. It's still 1.75, and the exemption is still on the 100 cedis. That is the threshold. As far as we are concerned, we of the minority are still at the zero rate position, because we have the tax laws already. We have the Income Tax Law Act 896 of 2015. Is there. So we will find out whether this imposition rhymes in with the provisions of chargeable income, accessible income. We will have to look at all of that.
Those who are calling for reduction in the e-levy, the question is, what work have they done to let Ghanaians know that the e-levy, if you reduce it by 1%, 0.5%, we are going to get X amount, and that X amount will be enough or adequate for us to perform our obligations. You don't, when it comes to finance and economics, you cannot just say anything at all. It is not possible. You deal with figures that are to be translated into reality to solve tangible and practical problems. So you cannot make any arbitrary statement at all. The fact of the matter is that there is no big difference between the e-levy you are talking about and the financial services tax.
You're still watching News 360 from the News Hub here at Addis Ababa, Kanda, in Accra. We're going to be bringing you some more stories, particularly relating to the NPP's National Delegates Conference, which is expected to happen over the weekend. We know that 38 proposals have been tabled for possible amendments, and we know that, among other things, the proposals include the election of a presidential candidate 2 years before a major election. And so, seeing behind me, these are some of the proposals that have been tabled for consideration during the delegates conference over the weekend. So, among other things, they're expecting MCEs to be constituency members and also former members of parliament to be part of the constituency executives. There's also the proposal for regional executives to supervise elections rather than persons appointed by the national executives. And so you will be seeing a lot more of those proposals that are being tabled by the NPP for possible affirmation or consideration during this delegates conference, which, by the way, we will be covering comprehensively if you stay with us on TV3 during the entire duration of that weekend. So those are some of the proposals that are coming through, and so we will be giving you updates as and when they become available. We know that all is set for the delegates conference, be it security, be it all the logistics that are needed to do this. So stay with us. We'll bring you all of those details.
Let's go back to Parliament, where the Finance Committee of the House has suspended the consideration of the e-levy bill 2021. Komla Kluche joins me on the telephone lines. Thank you so much for your time, Komla. What more can you report about this development?
Well, Portia, I can say that the Finance Committee has actually met, but they have not considered the electronic levy bill yet. In fact, details that we are getting from the minority was that it was suspended. But just a short while ago, I needed to get some confirmation from the government side. I just spoke with Information Minister Kodiopong Kuma, who is also a member of the Finance Committee. He tells me that they have not met and considered it yet because a lot of consultation are going on. And in just about some 15 minutes ago, the telcos have just released the statement because just about 2 days ago, he was saying that they were in talks with the telcos to see how best they'll be able to realign their charges for it to be commensurate with what they were going to be charging. But they were waiting for some of this consultations, and that this is coming, the more reason why the Finance Committee did not go into it, asking specifically if the committee will go into this or will consider this and the bill be passed before they rise, hopefully tonight. The stock that will be rising tonight, he said, is unable to tell because a lot of things are going on. A lot of the committees are also still taking their report on the estimate. But he was very clear that it has not been suspended, but that they have not considered it yet. And it's because of the consultations that they've been doing with the telcos and other stakeholders. So, yes, the Finance Committee has not considered it, but then it is most unlikely that it's also going to be taken before they rise, possibly tonight or tomorrow morning.
Thank you so much, Komla Kluche, for joining us, giving us this development.
You're still watching News 360 from the News Hub. If you stay with us after the break, we have business with Della Michelle.
I'm going to interview Zuzum right here in my house. Hey!
Look up there. Why are you using inferior pen?
It was a mistake. I know check you.
Acrobat too. I'm going to knock you out.
I know, sir.
You deserve quality.
Don't make mistakes. Stop.
You did the right thing.
When you are going to buy a paint, don't look left, don't look right. Go straight and grab the luxury acrylic paint. No be any paint, be paint.
The luxury acrylic paint.
Paint me champion.
Hello, my friends. My name is Kelkit Toothpaste. Wow. I was made to be gentle on your gum, but protected. I will protect your teeth from cavity, make your teeth whiter, stronger, keep your mouth fresh all day. And best of all, I'm strawberry flavored. So put on a smile and try me.
That's amazing.
Just try me. That's my job.
If you say so, jump on my brush.
Makes your teeth stronger,
chicky chicky
whiter,
chicky chicky
stronger.
Yay! You did it!
I'm glad you like your new toothpaste. Don't forget to brush both day and night.
Kelkit, happy smile.
We were totally crushed
when our child was diagnosed with cancer.
We knew we just couldn't afford the treatment. And then you came to our rescue through the Campbell antiseptic liquid because we care initiative.
Join us again to fight childhood cancer. All you have to do is to buy Camel antiseptic liquid and we will use 10 pesos to support the Because We Care initiative to help a child with cancer. Give 10 pesos, give hope. This advert is FDA approved.
Top of your game with Visa. Pay with Visa and win a two-night staycation for two at a luxury hotel. AFCON is proudly brought to you by Visa.
Freedom. It means different things to different people. To some, it was that speech back in 57. To others, it's the sounds and vibes of the land. Or simply sharing a sweet and memorable moment. To us, freedom means doing it our way. Introducing our limited edition Freedom Tags.
Grab yours and enjoy the taste of freedom.
For nice, still so nice. This advert is FDA approved.
Hello, you want 15,000 Ghana cities? Sapato de Bede.
Medebetho cement.
Yeah, me home sika kesia no menu super.
I'm going to go to the house.
Airtel Tigo. Life is simple.
I wish I could have soft and glowing skin.
New Geisha Black Soap. With activated charcoal to give you soft and glowing skin. New Geisha Black Soap and New Geisha Moringa.
We ask Orca customers, why do you shop at Orca?
Okay, so for me, it's a no-brainer because I can easily find everything that I need right here in Orca. I mean, look at this. Feels luxurious, but yet affordable. So that's my reason.
There are thousands of reasons to shop at Orca.
And for me, this is why I shop with Orca.
Visit our new store and find yours.
I love football. Football can be a dirty game, on or off the pitch. Even when I'm trying to score at a party, stains find a way of tracking me down. But I don't worry at all, because I have Cleansoft. Use new Cleansoft 360 Deep Clean, a unique formula with active ingredients and enzymes that gets rid of all stubborn stains and leaves your clothes smelling wonderful.
Cleansoft, my favorite.
Cleansoft 360 Deep Clean, clean all.
The business segment is brought to you by MTN,
Piccadilly Biscuits,
Roma Insecticide Spray and Coil,
West Hills Ridge Property, Eden Heights,
Camel Buy and Fly.
Hello there. Good evening. Let's bring you the latest in the world of business. My name is Adela Michelle. The Ghana Chamber of Telecommunications and its members have agreed on a downward revision of the person-on-to-person transfer by up to 25%, depending on the representative operator. Now, the move, according to the Chamber, is to cushion customers as the debate on the implementation of the e-levy rages on. According to the Chamber, which comprises the mobile money operators, Airtel Money Commerce Limited, that is Airtel Tigo Money, Mobile Money Limited, MTN Momo, Vodafone Ghana Mobile Financial Services Limited, that is Vodafone Cash, have all followed keenly the national decision on the e-levy policy and have engaged with various stakeholders. Now, the chamber has also extensively engaged government on the need to lessen the impact on the consumers. Each operator would notify their rate with the e-levy as the e-levy is being passed. Away from that, the Ghana stands to generate in excess of $2 billion in revenue and job creation annually if rice importation and other produce of comparative advantage are curtailed. The former president, John Dramani Mahama, made the observation when the Ghana Rice Interprofessional Body called on him in Accra.
Ghana's rice imports increased from 24,000 metric tons in 1971 to 950,000 metric tons in 2020, growing at an average annual rate of 12.53%. Though the nation's rice production as at 2020 stood at 681,000 metric tons, consumption outstrips local production, of which 66% is imported primarily from Thailand, Vietnam and India. The economic costs of relying on imported rice are high and rising. Between 2007 and 2015, the amount spent on imported rice rose from $151 million to $1.2 billion. This former president, John Dramani Mahama, finds worrying.
We need the capacity to process. If you bring in the capacity to process, the farmers will rise to the occasion. Yes. Of course, fertilizer and things are expensive, but if they get a fair price, you know, for the paddy, and the millers to get a fair markup for, you know, processing and selling, it will be a win-win partnership.
He added that continuous importation will only reduce Ghana's employment levels and enrich other nations.
Until we begin to look at a self-reliant, you know, attitude, and also to look at import substitution for critical products, there are at least six or seven products that we spend almost $2 billion every year importing. And can you imagine the number of jobs $2 billion will create in our economy?
The Ghana Rice Interprofessional Body paid a visit to former presidents John Dramani Mahama and John Ejekum Kufuor to champion the cause of promoting patronage and consumption of local rice. President of the body, Nana Ejaye II, called on government to ensure subsequent procurements target local rice.
Ghana rice has come a long way. Now we can compete with the Thailand and the Vietnamese rice. I had an opportunity to go to Thailand just to study what they do in rice, and I don't think they are doing anything different from what we are doing here. All that we need is a push.
The John Ejekum Kufuor Foundation, which over the years has assisted the body to execute its mandate, implored farmers to innovate with trends in the agricultural sector so they meet global standards.
We also appeal to the media to advertise Ghana rice, and let us all begin to promote Ghana rice. If we succeed in that, we can be saving this country more than $1 billion a year.
Meanwhile, government's Planting for Food and Jobs initiative is expected to increase rice production from its current state of 681,000 metric tons.
That's all the business news we have for you. There's more business news available on 3news.com. My name is Della Michelle. There's more news after the break. Stay with us.
There are many ways to get around, but there's only one way to pay.
Momo?
Sure.
So many styles to choose, but there's only one sure way to pay.
Momo?
Yes.
There's so many you can buy, but there's only one sure way to pay.
Momo?
Yes.
To share my enemy.
There's so much variety, but there's only one sure way to pay.
Momo, come on, yam.
There's so many ways to get together, but there's only one sure way to pay.
Momo. Hey, yes, Momo.
got a payment to make? Use MTN Momo and enjoy real convenience in all your financial transactions. Live life the brighter way with MTN Momo. Just Momo it. We day for you. Everywhere you go.
UMB was established in 1972 as the premier bank for the corporate and private sector in Ghana. From our very beginning, as the only Ghanaian bank serving all categories of businesses, we set a standard for excellence and innovation over the past 45 years. We've built a financially healthy and strong bank, demonstrated our commitment to our customers and to growing businesses, and exhibited originality and innovation at every turn. At UMB, our focus is built around people, service, products, and technology. These are the key to our present success and our future triumphs. At UMB, we're poised to make a difference not only with our customers, but also in the banking industry. We invite you to share in our future. Our future starts now with you.
The groom is sick.
What?
Malaria.
Malaria. Lufat. Lufat.
In Jaja, who are malaria and kawon to them? Lufat, aye malaria dropper kope.
And now you may kiss the bride.
Entrance Pharmaceuticals and Research Center. And aye Lufat, Lufat, a two malaria sententem. FDA, ashesa etedi inkratwe ajatumse aye.
Epsilon Nature Essentials, charcoal and lemon essence restores natural white teeth. Herbal extract for strong teeth and healthy gums. Antibacterial toothpaste that protects you and your family. Because every smile matters.
See how oily I am? It will take forever to clean this.
Take it easy, Pan. Your days of endless scrubbing are over. My dad just bought Sunlight Dishwash Liquid.
What do you know about a pan's life?
This advanced formulation has real lemon juice that will cut through all those stains fast in just one wipe.
Wow, that was fast.
See how easy it is to remove oil in one wipe? New Sunlight Dishwash Liquid removes oil stains in just one wipe.
This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
It's the season of gifting, and Samsung is making you the offer of the season. Look cool and feel good when you step out this Christmas. Get your crystal clear sound from your favorite artist, and HD quality screen pictures and movies. Yes, you can have it all.
When you wake up in the morning, before you start your day,
breakfast time is Kellogg time.
For work and for play, for a great start to your day,
breakfast time is Kellogg time.
We always start our day with a nourishing Kellogg's breakfast, powered with the goodness of grains and 11 essential vitamins and minerals. So in our family, breakfast time is Kellogg's time.
This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
Shed your rumor to me.
Atonton Master, be here to my number.
Kiss all my daddy.
Roma insecticide spray at that Roma. Interfre, Intatia, make a cheha. No way.
Kemikuno,
Atonton Baco Crown Panama.
I'm also a pussy.
Roma insecticide spray and mosquito cream. I'm out there with a shell.
Roma,
Equine.
Roma and Tonton Master.
Sports segment is brought to you by
Kel Kids Toothpaste,
Consolidated Bank Ghana, CBG.
Uh,
Hello, good evening. Time now to do sports here on News 360. My name is Yao Ofusula. To our first story. And we start off from the camp of the Black Stars, and president of the Ghana Football Association, Ketu Kreku, says the technical team of the Black Stars will give any player the opportunity in the team, despite reports about Southampton defender Mohamed Salisu rejecting Ghana's call-up. Ghana will be competing for the coveted Continental Trophy with 23 other African countries when the tournament commences in Yaoundé, Cameroon on January 9, 2022.
Playing for a national team does not start and stop with the AFCON. Beyond the AFCON, there is the World Cup qualification games. Beyond that, there's AFCON qualification games for 2023, etc., etc. So our ambition is to build national teams that are very competitive and that will win medals or trophies for our dear country. And players who are willing and who love their country will be given the opportunity to show their love to their country.
And on some more stories, and Ghana Premier League champions Hearts of Oak have confirmed that their league game with Accra Lions will be played at the Cape Coast Sports Stadium on Sunday, December 19, 2021. The venue changed due to renovation work scheduled to be done at the Accra Sports Stadium, as announced by the National Sports Authority. A club statement from Hearts of Oak confirmed the change in venue for their league game and encouraged fans to let their support count by filling the stands on Sunday in Cape Coast. Well, let's check out the Ghana Premier League fixtures for this weekend there. And Accra Hearts of Oak taking on Accra Lions, as I mentioned earlier. But on Sunday, the games are as follows. Adriana Stars will take on Brekum Chelsea. Real Tamale United, who drew 1-1 with Kumasi Asantekotoko in midweek, will take on Elmina Sharks. And then Wafa will face Medeama SC. Karela will take on Bechem United. Legon City's Football Club will take on Kumasi Asantekotoko. And then 11 Wonders will take on BBNE Gold Stars. Hearts of Oak will play Accra Lions, as I mentioned earlier. On Monday, Ashanti Gold will be at the Obuasi Link Clay Sports Stadium, where they take on Great Olympics. And King Faisal will face Dreams on Tuesday. Well, that's all the sports news this evening here on News 360. My name is Yao Ofusula. Entertainment news and international news after the break.
Watch out, if you blue, I saw a bunch of sugar crack.
Yeah, yeah.
Watch out, blue house, we are
new. Minty, minty.
Ghana for paint. Agatex paint.
Agatex.
Paint papa. Say, are you blue? Are you blue? Kakra, you know here.
No, that's not
come on. The boss is so cost, bro.
And the Agatex.
You pass all.
Do engagement now. Let's move by. Mama Agatex. I can see you.
We need more for bringing your
money. Oh, that's what I said.
Na edru menso meso se medi abusian hie muye ni omo omu jaje adie bia obeye no so beba ho bi
e wo se wo di kra no to school foforo mu
un se mrom so dodo
debi sister want to mendre sister
e wo se wo nya akokodro won hie ye bia obeye ho impo se nipa nyina na wo nya adwe emum adie ba kwa wo nyina agitum ne wadua ne no adedede ni ni hwampa pa bia anwo di draw wo mu.
Any fair, any said your paste in a pea. Now you have the fiber, any vitamins that can want you. Tasty Tom and Rich Tomato Mix may be seen in a dunya at day. As Sansoma wanting.
Tasty Tom and Rich Tomato Mix. Strength comes from within.
This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
We'll be right back.
Yes.
VIP.
Magnetic perfumes.
Dream.
I'm hosting the family get together because I make the best potato salad.
I've got DSTV. Choose joy. Choose an HD decoder plus 1 month DSTV access for only $169 cedis and enjoy every moment with DSTV.
Globo is the app that brings you anything you want, like some crispy chicken and ending the day in a big way, or what you need from the supermarket right away. Order a Globo and we'll deliver.
Electromart sells brand new and authentic brands only, like LG, Sony, Broom, Samsung, Panasonic, Philips, Midea, TCL, Orient, Tamashii, Solartec, Kaiser, and a lot more. Now, this is what customers say about Electromart.
I shop at Electromart because they offer guarantee and warranties on any product you buy from here.
Electromart sells quality product and they offer excellent after-sales service support.
Electromart, your world of electronics.
Hi, I'm Didier Drogba. On average, almost 250,000 people die on the road in Africa each year. As a proud African, this breaks my heart knowing that so many deaths could have been avoided. So when you're on the road, follow these safe steps and help save lives. Remember, no person is too big or too small to avoid the effects of alcohol. Just one drink can increase the risk of a serious crash. Once it's in your blood system, the only remedy is time. Short-term remedies such as coffee, cold showers, or energy drinks don't help. If you need to travel after a drink, be responsible. Take a taxi or public transport, or just stay where you are. So when you're on the road, follow these safe steps and help save lives. We all have a role to play in road safety. Together, let's make Africa's road safer.
Entertainment news segment is brought to you by Vodafone, a wick purified drinking water.
Tonight in this segment, 2021 Big Brother Niger Season 6, Shine Your Eye housemate Emmanuel Umo arrived in Ghana and received a rousing welcome from his Ghanaian fans. This is Emmanuel's first trip to Ghana to meet and greet his fans after he took part in the reality show. Speaking to the entertainment team, he expressed excitement to be in Ghana.
Fans of former Big Brother Niger star Emmanuel Umo mobbed him at the Kotoka International Airport on his first visit to Ghana after the show. Due to the hit reality show that airs in many countries across Africa, housemates like Emmanuel have gathered huge fan base from several countries. The fashion icon and entrepreneur landed at the Kotoka International Airport Friday afternoon, December 17th, and is expected to tour the country, meet up with fan base this festive season. His visit comes months after some housemates flew to Ghana to meet with their fans to appreciate them for their support and votes whilst in the competition. Speaking to the entertainment team, he expressed his excitement to be in Ghana.
Hey, what's up, Africa? It's Emmanuel here in Accra, Ghana. So I came to, you know, meet my friends, with my family. I mean, Ghana is my family. Emirates, I love you guys so much. I came to meet Emirates family. The plan, yeah, is to be here for a few days, but with the love and attention I'm getting, Omo, happy day, your passport. Massive, yeah. I have a couple of things lined up, yeah. A few media rounds, a few meet and greet, a few events. I think Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week, yeah, I'll be there. And of course, I'm here to party too with my friends.
But how does it feel to know that you have all these numbers down here in Ghana?
Honestly, I'm amazed. and I'm surprised. I mean, despite the fact that I came pretty late and I still have this massive crowd waiting for me, I feel loved.
Now, Burna Boy's feature in Black Sheriff's second Sermon remix has shot the Ghanaian artists to billboards all over Nigeria. In a viral video on social media mounted, billboards were sighted displaying visuals of Blacko and Burna Boy with trending songs playing in the background. And you know that the song released in December 8 has gained over 735,000 views on YouTube and has received positive reactions since its release. That'll be all for entertainment news.
Hey guys. So it's day 3 of eating well. Fitspod!
Why are you doing this to yourself?
Cheat day?
Just try Nutri Snacks. It's like cheat day every day, the tasty way.
Made with wheat, oats, and delicious goodness. Nutri Snacks Oats Digestive Biscuit. Tasty goodness. This advertisement is FDA approved.
Water gives life. Water is life. Enjoy the pure, refreshing taste of Awake purified drinking water, which comes in a uniquely designed bottle with a lemon green tap. Water is your perfect way to stay hydrated. And remember, for every bottle you buy, an amount will be donated to the National Cardiothoracic Center, Ghana. Awake purified drinking water. One for life.
For bulk purchase, contact 0262-351-251.
This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
See, you gotta have a smile, no matter what it takes. Then you gotta take Perk Down, Perk Down. Love the way it tastes. Feel the perky buzz from your toes to your face. Say oh 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 oh. You gotta take Perk Down, Perk Down, Perky it today. Say oh 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 oh. You gotta take Perk Down, Perk Down, Perky it today. Say oh 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 oh. You gotta take Perk Down, Perk Down, Perky it today.
Perk up anywhere, even at home, with the rich, milky taste of Peck Biscuits. This advert is FDA approved.
Freedom. It means different things to different people. To some, it was that speech back in 57. To others, it's the sounds and vibes of the land. Or simply sharing in sweet and memorable moments. To us, freedom means doing it our way. Introducing our limited edition Freedom Tags.
Grab yours and enjoy the taste of freedom.
For nice, still so nice. This advert is FDA approved.
Russia has demanded strict limits on the activities of the US-led NATO military alliance in the country's neighboring borders. Tension has been rising between Russia and Western countries who fear Russia plans to invade its neighbor, Ukraine. Russia denies this, but says NATO must rule out Ukraine and others ever joining NATO to defuse the situation. Moscow wants urgent talks with the US, but its proposals are being viewed as a non-starter in Washington. Responding to Moscow's calls for direct negotiations with the US, White House spokeswoman told reporters, quote, "There will be no talks on European security without our European allies and partners," unquote.
That'll be our show for tonight. It came to you from a news hub at Adisawe Kanda in Accra. I am Komla Adom.
And I am Portia Gabo. Have a lovely weekend.
Of citrusy encourages healthy skin, helps boost your immune system, and helps fight colds. Citrusy contains antioxidants, which slows down your aging process and make you look and feel younger, plus a lot more. Citrusy promotes general good health for the entire family. Take citrusy.